students, let us talk about how you can work with database in JSP. For example, તમે એવી કોઈ વેબસાઇટ બનાવી છે જેમાં સર્વર સાઇડ તમે JSPનો યુઝ કર્યો છે અને ડેટાબેઝમાં MySQL યુઝ કર્યું છે. ડેટાબેઝ ટૂલમાં ગમે તે યુઝ કરી શકો. ઇટ ઇઝ ઓલ અબાઉટ ધ કોમ્પેટેબિલિટી. નાવ સપોઝ મારું ડેટાબેઝ ટૂલ છે MySQL, જેમાં મારે એક ડેટાબેઝ બનાવવાનું છે એમ્પ્લોય, જેમાં એક ટેબલ બનાવવાનું છે ઇન્ફો, અને જેમાં બે ફિલ્ડ્સ છે, એમ્પ્લોય નંબર એન્ડ એમ્પ્લોય નેમ. નાવ આ ડેટાબેઝની અંદર આઈ વિલ પરફોર્મ ધ ઓપરેશન ફ્રોમ JSP. ક્લાયન્ટ સાઇડ કોઈ બી લેંગ્વેજનો યુઝ કરી શકું, HTML, CSS, JavaScript, jQuery, AJAX. સર્વર સાઇડ આઈ એમ યુઝિંગ JSP અને મારું ડેટાબેઝ બનાવેલું છે MySQL. સો લેટ અસ ફર્સ્ટ સ્ટાર્ટ હાઉ ટુ ક્રિએટ ધ ડેટાબેઝ ઇન MySQL. નાવ ફોર દેટ ફર્સ્ટ યુ સ્ટાર્ટ યોર MySQL સર્વિસ. સો ફોર દેટ આઈ હેવ ઇન્સ્ટોલ્ડ XAMPP. Now this is the XAMPP control panel. Now you start your Apache, MySQL and Tomcat. These three services you should start. Once it has been started, it will display here. Minimize the control panel, or you can also close it. These three has been started. Now close the control panel. Now open your browser. Now let us first check whether MySQL service is working or not. So for that, write down localhost. And PHP MyAdmin. So it is displaying your PHP MyAdmin. Now PHP MyAdmin is the user interface in which you can create your MySQL database. Now here I have created the employee database. I already have created the employee database. Now let us first drop it and then we will create it again. So select the database, then go to operations, then drop the database and OK. So it will drop your database. Now let us create the new database. Give the name here, say it is employee, and create. Now you can give here your table name, so it is info. Now the number of columns are 2 and go. Now here give the name of your field. So very first is employee number, data type is integer, and length is say 5. Now next is employee name, data type is worker, here you can give any value, say 10, and save. Click the save button. So here it have created database employee, then table info, and here two fields have been created. This is the structure of your table. Here you can change also. If you want to change the structure, these all are the options available here. Now let us insert some rows into the table. So here press the insert button. Now give the values here. You can give any value. Say employee number is 1. Here select any value and go. So click here info. So it has inserted one row. Now again perform, insert 2-3 rows, say 2, values are, you can enter any value, insert more rows, so here I have inserted 3 rows. Now let us access this database from JSP, that means from Java code. Now for that, you already have started Tomcat. Now go to your Tomcat folder. In C drive, I have installed XAMPP. In XAMPP, go to Tomcat folder. in Tomcat locate the WebApps folder. In WebApps folder, you can create any folder. I have created the test folder. Now in test folder, I have already created that program for displaying the rows of the table. So this is my file. Open it with any editor, say Notepad. See, this is my program to access the rows of the table. Now this is the JSP file I have created, and it is used to display all the rows of the table. Now let us explain each and every row. This is my JSP tag and this is my page directive. Now in page directive, you can give two attributes. You can give any number of attributes. I have given two attributes only, language and import statement. Now as I am going to use the connectivity with the database, I need this package java.sql.star. So I have imported it. Now I need these three reference variables of connection interface, statement interface and result interface. So I have created three reference variables. Now this is the forName method. Now forName method is used to locate the driver for the MySQL database. So it is the method of class is the name of class. So if your drivers are not installed properly, then this method will give the error. Now getConnection method is used to connect with your MySQL database. So it is localhost employees, the database you have created. Root and blank are the default username and passwords to create with the MySQL database. Now create the statement. Now for that, create statement method is used. Now execute the query. Now your query is select star from info. Info is your table name. Now whenever you are performing the select operation, that at that time you need to use the create statement method, and it is the method of connection interface. So it is called with the interface reference variable of connection interface. Now execute the query. Now as this table will return multiple rows, so on HTML page you can create the table using the trtd tags, so that in that table you can display the values written from the info table. So here table tag is used to create the table. Then in tr, that means you are creating the first row and you are giving the headings employee number and employee name. Now in rs is the reference of result set interface. So it will catch all the rows returned from this query select star from info. And next is the method of rs, so that you can traverse from first row to last row, and you are getting the values from your result set using this get integer and get string methods. As your first field is the integer, is of integer data type, and second field is of worker data type. So here you are displaying the rows using the get integer and get string methods. So this is how your program will work. Now let us run this program in the browser. As your Tomcat is already running, open your browser, open the new tab, locate your Tomcat, that is localhost 8080, where your Tomcat service is running. Test use is your folder and your file name is dis.jsp. Run the program. So here you are getting the table and values from the info table from employee database. Now here this is your employee database. These three are the records you have created, and these three records you are displaying on JSP page using this program. So this is how you can display the database values on JSP page. So this is how you can access the database using JSP. Thank you.